Good morning. I just realized that I haven't actually brushed my teeth yet this morning, but you can't tell because this is a video. How grim is that? Oh, I'm going to SoulCycle this morning to go and work out, and I'm not awake yet. Oh, I need me some socks. Got a full Sweaty Betty outfit on today. This Sweaty Betty top. Actually, this bra is Lululemon, and these Sweaty Betty pants. I'll ignore my clothes from last night, which are great because they hug everything in and sculpt you, which I like. I'm going to SoulCycle this morning, and I should have left about 10 minutes ago. Yeah, 13 and 14. But Liv always makes fun of me because I get the lightest weights they have. I get 1 kilo, but they do like such a long weight training. I need the 1 kilo.
All that she wants is another baby.
That's her playlist.
Yeah, she did a great playlist. Normally we don't really try new teachers, but she was.
I find it really weird though going to SoulCycle and having an English teacher because like I associate it so much with America.
Yeah.
And like the accents.
I didn't like the one that we went to live, but I liked her.
Yeah, same.
Lauren.
I think that was
she was great.
It was an easier class though. Yeah. It's been a lot. So.
And also we like the music. I don't like it when it's like housey. I like songs I can sing to. It's more fun.
And then I was singing along. No one can hear you, so it's fine.
Oh, could you hear me? And no, I can hear you.
We
I didn't
very
hear you singing,
today.
But I sing.
The girl next to us was like trying to sing with us, and I was like, girl, we are vibing. We are just like
bop. It looks so cool when you bop together.
It's like moving in time.
We're gonna go for breakfast now at 2:02 in Notting Hill. Then have some, I really feel like some smoked salmon or something like salty. Stop. Halfway through my tummy started rumbling and I was like,
do you eat before you
like? No, do you?
Can't when it's morning.
When I work out like so early, I don't get hungry. Smoked salmon crew.
Literally.
Lols.
You know what I realize I need to stop saying? Like randomly when I have nothing to say, I just say lols
and mort.
And mort!
Lols, mort, and lit need to go. They're like my new things, like they've gotta go. Productive start to the day. Done. Had my smoked salmon. I need to wash my hair desperately. Look at all these annoying little fluffy bits that just come out like these little baby hairs. I never know what to do with them. I straighten them, but then they still kind of make me look a bit, I don't know. I don't really know, a bit strange. They really bother me. All right, where did I park my car? Oh, it's such a gorgeous day, but it's so cold. My way to home, I would go to Whole Foods and get some of my favorite snacks. My snack cupboard at the moment at the house currently consists of these oat cakes, which you know when you eat something when you're sick and then it reminds you of being sick? I can't even look at them. Oh, they give me the shudders because I was so, so sick. And all I could eat were these oat cakes because I just needed to eat something to have medicine. And so I'd eat those. Now I literally like, oh, I need to throw them away because they are so gross. They really give me the shivers. I don't want them. So that's the only thing in my snack cupboard. I desperately need to snack it up in my house because I went from Thanksgiving the other night and I finished all the leftover chocolate and sweets. I have no snacks, no healthy snacks, no snacks in general. So I thought if I go to Whole Foods, then that would be a good place to start and get some nice little exciting things. Make me like motivated to cook and eat healthier.
Oh my God, this section smells so good. Oh, I thought that was heart-shaped for a second. That's so funny. Oh my God, this smells amazing. Come to mama. Ooh, a pretzel stick. No, 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 we are being healthy people. Healthy. Ooh, mochi. Okay, no. We're going downstairs. Let's be honest, these are the real reason why I'm here. This is my favorite flavor, the caramel almond. They're so good.
There was a mom in Whole Foods. Sorry. And she had these two, I think they looked like twins with her, and she was looking after them whilst like trying to food shop, and it just looked like wow. I mean, one of them, Harry, I spent a lot of time following her around. We were doing the same route, so I got to know his name. Was like, I want chocolate milk, and she was like, no, Harry, we have chocolate milk at home. I can't get you chocolate milk now. And he was like, no, I want it now. And he was like screaming. She was like, Harry, no. And then her other baby started crying, and I was like, oh my god, this looks so hard. Honestly, mums, I see you. Wow. I mean, respect to the mums. Looks so hard. I don't know how you do that. I felt like I just wanted to go and help her, but even though it probably wouldn't be much help, and I definitely would make the situation worse, so I didn't.
I know I just had breakfast, but these guys, I cannot resist. Dunks, they're the best. Oh yeah. Mmm, so good. You literally dip the biscuit into the thing. Right, I'm gonna be honest. I mainly went to Whole Foods for this. I'll show you what else I got. Sorry. I always talk with my mouth full, don't I, when I'm eating snacks. These are so good. It's like Barocca, but without the sugar. It's called NRC. They have pink ones, which are like raspberry flavor, which I don't like. This is the lemon flavor. It's great, it's just vitamin C. I have one all the time. Then, this is my favorite dark chocolate. I don't normally like dark chocolate, but it's cacao, which is like healthier for you, you know? And this is the orange one, but this texture, some of them are quite hard because they don't have milk in them, but this texture is so soft, it like melts in your mouth. Oh, it's so good. What else did I get? Oh, I got some chestnuts because I love roasting chestnuts. Oh god, I picked up a basket in it and it had someone's thing in it, then they put it in my bag. Got some seaweed crisps, they're so yummy. Put that on. I got these Deliciously Ella breakfast bars. And oh, I got my favorite almond milk. Now, I am a big almond milk reader abouter. I read a lot about almond milk because basically loads of almond milk have added sugar in them and they don't actually have that much almond in them and it's mainly just water. But this one, normally almonds in almond milk is like 2%, but this is 6%. So that's much better and it doesn't have any added sweetener or anything. Almonds are quite sweet anyway. I don't really feel like I need sweetener in almond milk. All right, let's rock and roll. Back. Oh! Hello.
Hi. This is very conveniently placed cupboard. Okay, we're trying to light this fire and I'm dead petrified of fires. So let's see what's Ross's video.
What's the cup for?
I don't really know. So first we put in some of this like oily stuff. You understand? Okay. In here. I don't really know how much to put in. I don't really understand the point of this.
I would do a little bit just like that. That must be alcohol in order to like for the fire to turn on.
I'm scared, Pia.
You don't do anything. You don't switch anything on underneath. Ooh.
Yeah, it's on. It worked.
Oh my god!
Yay! Yay!
Oh wow.
That's fire enough.
I mean, it just looks like the thing you get on top of a Christmas cake, you know what I mean?
Yes!
Like that blue.
On the pudding!
I feel like
it's getting up.
Yeah, I feel like it'll warm up. Okay, yay.
Just sat down and I have officially put on the first fire in my house.
Look how pretty it is. The first fire in my house. I'm so happy. And I have my two Diptyque candles next to it. Oh.
And in honor of my first fire, I am taking a Instagram and you will see this on my Instagram probably very soon. Oh, it looks so cool behind me, doesn't it? I hope my hair doesn't catch fire. But you'll see this Instagram very soon. It features a face mask that I absolutely love from Garnier. And I'm shooting that now. Got my pillows next to me and we're ready to rock and roll.
All right, we got the new snacks up in here. The current snack cupboard situation, which is a bit of a disaster. I mean, like it's not even organized. I have some random like coffee mugs and tea mugs in here. And my tea is here. I really have barely been here 2 weeks and I already need to organize this cupboard. So let's get cracking. take a look inside my little snack cupboard. Got my tea over there. My olive oil didn't fit with all my sauces and honeys and other things, so it's down there. I'm not sure what I'm going to do with it. I might put it in this corner here, actually. And then I have my NOC. I have all my sweet treats and things. All my Livia's dunks here. Got my mugs. And then I have, like, dry foods up here and sauces, separating them in the middle. That was very easy. And it looks much better now, I think. This box just arrived at my house and I know what's inside and I am so excited about this. This is from a brand that actually I got Liv a present from her wedding. I found them on Instagram and then I bought her this Mrs. B bag, which I knew that she wanted. And then they contacted me because I kept showing it on my feed what I got Liv and said, would I like a bespoke bag? And look at this. Oh my gosh! Wow! This is amazing! Oh my goodness! Oh my gosh! Look! Inside! Come on, open! Let's see. Oh my gosh, it's like green silk inside. You can make them fully bespoke. So I went with emerald because I have an emerald dress that this would go really well with. It's actually Hannah's dress. And it says Amelia Liana on it. Oh my gosh. I'll show you the dress I had in mind that I wanted to wear this with that kind of inspired this bag. Where is it? I mean, you guys know green is my favorite color to wear, but this dress, oh my gosh, it's gonna look amazing with that, isn't it? Liv actually just got me this SoulCycle tracksuit in the sale. Look how cute it is. It's so sweet, the little tie-dye. I really love it. Anyway, back to this bag. Oh my gosh, it's so pretty. I've just kind of left it here because I don't know what to do with it. Oh my gosh!
Basically, the full story with this bag, sorry, I'm just tidying up my room and this postman just came, is that for Liv's wedding, I knew she wanted a Mrs. B bag and it was kind of inspired by the Edie Parker bags and we looked into getting them for each other and the Edie Parker ones were like £2,000, I think. Bespoke, they were totally crazy. So actually, I think the reason why I found this brand, Roya, is because I put on my stories, where can I get one? This like specific type of clutch, but that isn't crazy expensive. And so many of you guys recommended it. And I'm so happy with this because it's so beautiful. So, oh, I'm very excited about that. I think I might go and put it in my wardrobe. Let's do this. Oh.
Alrighty, where do you belong? I think right up here, like that. What do you guys think? Oh, let me straighten that out. There we go. Yes. This one needs to go somewhere else, actually. Maybe I'll put this one here. I might wear that bag tonight. There we go. Oh, yeah. Holy smokes. We have another delivery. A Charlotte Tilbury stocking that says my name on it. This needs to be opened this instant. Oh my goodness. Oh crap. Oh my gosh. Whoa, that's huge. There's so much more in here. Oh, I'm getting out of breath in excitement. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Whoa.
All right, let's have a look. Charlotte's Magic Gift Shop. Oh, there's a card. Sorry, my hair is in desperate need of sorting out before going out tonight, but I'm having a nice home day. Oh, darling. This holiday, I want to gift magic. Oh, this is so exciting. Okay, let's see what we have here. We have Magic Dreams award-winning skincare. So Magic Cream, Magic Night Cream, and Magic Dreams. Relax, Amelia. Magic Dreams eye mask. I'm gonna link all these down below because there are so many amazing Charlotte Tilbury Christmas gifts and they're just wrapped so nicely. Like if you're a terrible wrapper like me, this would be amazing. This is the Bright Magic Skin. So we have Brightening Youth Glow and a mini magic cream. I'm actually gonna keep that because I just ran out of my magic cream. So I desperately need another one because I use it so much. My mum is actually obsessed with it now too. We have the Hollywood Beauty Glow. Oh, this is one of my favorite products ever. It's so great. And it has a Wonder Glow in there as well. Oh my gosh, there's just so much here. Filmstar Bronze and Glow we have here. We have a mini brush set. What else is in here? Oh my god, this is so cute. Mini hot lips. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Oh my god. Mini. Why is it that something mini is just way better than anything else? That's such a cute color. JK Magic. So sweet, aren't they? I love them. Oh, sorry, you're probably looking at my hair like, what is going on with her hair? I don't know is the answer to that question. I don't know what to tell you. The gift of Pillow Talk, so we have a lip cheat and a matte revolution, which is what I'm wearing on my lips right now. It's like the only makeup I have on. What else do we have? Oh, this is my mum's favorite, so instant look at a palette. Wait, but they do different ones every year. Ooh, this is like more of a purpley evening one. I'm literally just gonna give this all to my mum. This is her favorite stuff. Legendary Eyes. This was the big baby. This is amazing, isn't it? Oh my gosh, look at that. Oh, I'm just so overwhelmed. I don't know what. Oh, luxury palette of Pops. Wow, this is so exciting. I feel so spoilt by such an amazing, amazing brand. And then we also have Superstar Lips, but glossy. Oh, I love her glossy lips. Oh, this is so exciting. What's this color? This is Princess Kiss. You guys, this is amazing. Oh, makeup is just so exciting. Ooh, let's try this. I don't have this one. That is nice. I love her glossy lipsticks. Something about a gloss. I mean, my face just kind of transformed with that gloss, I think. That's a great color. Love that. Princess Kiss. Woo! Oh my gosh, I have so much Charlotte Tilbury stuff around me now. Ah, I don't know what to do with it all. It's so exciting. Should we see the brush set as well? A magical brush set. I love her marketing. Like, it does make you feel so special with all the special little names. Oh, this is a little blue pouch. And inside, oh, I love the brushes. Inside, we have mini.
I have to say, guys, M&S flowers are really the one. Like, look at these beautiful roses. There's so many of them. It's almost, I think it was $9.99 for a bouquet of roses. And they look so pretty and happy. And they're so beautiful. Maybe these ones need some room to open up a bit. I love them. Let's open up day two. Oh, it's a candle. This is my Dior advent calendar. I'm not sure if they're still on sale, but if it is, I'll link it down below. And this is an amber candle. It's quite a good size, isn't it? I'm just trying on a new dress that arrived. I still have nothing in this room, by the way, from one of my Black Friday sales. And I don't think it's going to be on sale anymore when you're watching this, but I wanted to show it to you anyway because I mentioned it in the haul. And I think it's great, this little leg slit with a little belt. It's really nice because jumper dresses often kind of drown you. But this belt is great for adding a little bit of definition. And then if we come through here, oh my gosh, if anyone has any ideas for what to do with my office, please let me know. I need to, lol that I put that box there. But I need to sort it out somehow, someday, in the near future. Ugh, I just don't want it to become my room of doom, you know? Because, I mean, right now in here I have pills and things. And in here I have podcast and recording equipment. Like, under there I have my laundry basket. It's just all a bit of a situation. So, I don't know, maybe I should decorate the shelves. I built this IKEA chair recently. I was so proud of myself for building it, even though it's just a chair. I just find IKEA building things so confusing. The manuals and stuff, but I don't really know what to do with this room. If you have any ideas, let me know, because I don't even know where to start. I feel like I need to commit to do it, like, next week or something, and then I'll vlog it. That will make me actually do it if I vlog it, I think. Anyway, I have just been putting the final touches on the podcast, which has gone up already. It is with a wonderful woman called Misty. Her name's Misty Sansom. I actually found her on Instagram, and she is a life purpose coach. And I kind of wanted to talk about it because I was speaking about this with a friend about
kind of the new phase of my life, I guess, really, and talking about the kind of big blank page. And that was what I actually mentioned in last week's episode with Estee. Well, it wasn't last week's, but it was the week before that with Estee, talking about kind of like restarting over your life, basically, and where to begin with that. And that was something that I wanted to talk about with Misty in particular, because she is a life purpose coach, and how to go about doing that, how to find your strengths and your weaknesses when, like, you don't know them in yourself because you're just so weak inside, basically, and how to go about finding purpose in your daily life when, like, you just really you really don't feel like it. So that is an episode that I feel like I opened up a lot in. I feel really grateful that I have that space on the podcast to open up in. I feel like it's so different opening up on the podcast to opening up on YouTube, because the podcast, I guess, if people are commenting on it and stuff, they're going out their way to, like, comment on my Instagram or my YouTube about it, whereas on YouTube the comments there are less nice, if that makes sense. So I feel like I don't know, maybe that's just me, but I feel like I can be much more vulnerable, much more open on my podcast. And someone actually, I bumped into someone the other day and they were telling me about their breakup. They were actually getting divorced and they were crying in the street and then I was crying, and it was all a bit much, and she literally said the only thing getting her through was my podcast. And I was like, oh my gosh, I could cry just talking about it. I was like, that is and was my intention of this podcast so much. So I am actually going to be speaking to a divorce lawyer that kind of inspired this new podcast episode that will be coming in a couple of weeks. So if anyone has any questions, I feel like for me especially, I would just find it interesting to speak to a divorce lawyer. They must see so many breakups and so many relationships ending, or maybe even getting back together, you know. So if anyone has any specifics they want me to talk about with the divorce lawyer, then please let me know. I feel like it's going to be a really juicy episode. Let's turn this light off, close this door to the room of doom. I'm not gonna have a room of doom in this house. I know everyone has a room of doom, including me. I'm the queen of the room of doom. I coined the room of doom, but I'm not going to have a room of doom, people. Future me just popping in as I'm editing this vlog to tell you that this Monday the 9th of December, I can't believe I forgot to tell you this, I'm having a charity sale, a beauty sale. It is going to be all brand new, amazing luxury beauty products at discounted prices. It is for a charity called Rays of Sunshine, which is an absolutely gorgeous charity. I will leave a link to them down below. The tickets are £5 and that is a full donation. It goes straight to Rays of Sunshine, and I will obviously be there waiting for you. And if you want to see what it was like, then I did one last year and you can watch the vlog down below to see what to expect and what products to expect and everything. But it is going to be amazing, and yeah, I hope you'll come, and I'll leave tickets down below. Good evening. I am getting ready for tonight, and it is one of those evenings where I just want to take absolutely ages getting ready. Having a girls' night tonight. What time even is it? Oh my god. I have 45 minutes until I need to leave, and I'm actually having the best time I've just been spending. I started getting ready 20 minutes ago, and I've only done my eyeshadow and I haven't even finished it. Like, it's one of those evenings where I just feel like taking absolute yonks getting ready. Like, I don't even know what's come over me tonight. And you know, one of those times when, I don't know if you do this, but I'm like, I am going to spend so long on my makeup and it's gonna look so different. So far it ain't looking that different, not gonna lie. So let's see how this goes and see where we get to on this makeup front. Tonight I'm going to a restaurant called Isabel's, and I haven't been that often. Oh, all my eyeliners are out, but the menu is so good, and everything is like really cute little sharing portions. I'm going with a couple of girls, one of whom you might know from my stories from Mykonos. Her name's Gemma. Oh, come on, eyeliner. Give me something. Give me anything. Anything you got. Oh, just about. Crap. Oh, snap. Do I do a wing? Do I not do a wing? It's like the never-ending struggle of wings or no wings. I'm going for a wing. Oh. All right, so as you know, I probably have shown you, actually I showed you in Vlogmas day one, that I have a dressing table upstairs that I just got, and I haven't actually used it yet. I need to like set it up properly, set up all my makeup there. But this lighting, I need it to be a bit brighter for me to actually do my makeup. But I have this amazing mirror coming. It's like a light up mirror. So I'm kind of waiting for that before I set up my whole dressing table situation upstairs. I have to say, you know, I was really not a big fan of Glossier when it launched. I was not excited by it at all. I didn't try any of their products. And recently I've tried two. This eyeliner, which is amazing, even though it's running out now, which is a bit sad. And this amazing waterproof eye makeup remover. I mean, I'm quite disappointed because it's 100 milliliters, which is quite small, I think. And it's like quite a small little bottle, but it is potent stuff, let me tell you. It's one of the best waterproof eye makeup removers I think I've ever used. Right, let me try and make this wing match. Bear with me. Oh, bloody love mascara. Alrighty. Spent literally half an hour on my eyes and they look no different to usual. This foundation is such life. It gives you the best glow. I have been obsessed with it since I did a Becca event with Harrods, and that was even maybe in summer, you know? Now it's winter. Anyway, it's Becca Skin Love Foundation. I'm gonna use my beauty blender today. I have actually put this Glossier product on underneath, which is, oh crap, it's a bit dark, isn't it? Oh crap, good thing it's nighttime. The Future Dew by Glossier, it does give you the most incredible glow. There is a Glossier pop-up in London actually right now, and I really want to go because it is what a brand that I am loving. ATM. Okay, there we go. Let's try and blend this in with my good old sponge. This foundation, make my skin look a bit more, you know, lifeful. I just want to tell you something else actually. I'm on a roll tonight. In this week's podcast episode, I talk about like kind of redefining my title, and I kind of get really deep about how I've defined myself my whole life really. And if you've listened to it, then you'll know what I'm talking about. And if not, I will leave a link to it down below. I also am not like, I know people think I'm social, but I'm very like reserved. Oh no, you know, I'm not reserved. What's the word I'm looking for? I guess like set in my ways. In terms of friendships and stuff. So it's been a kind of different experience for me to make close friends later on. And that was something that I just wanted to mention today. If anyone's thinking the same thing, just to keep an open mind, you know. But I do speak more about that on the podcast as well. So basically, that is where I open up now about life. Make sure you tune in. I actually have the best guest coming up next week. I don't want to spoil it yet. But I'm so, so, so excited for you to meet her. Well, you might already know her actually, but if you don't, you are in for a treat. And if you do, you're gonna be thrilled because I've mentioned her in her writings before. Yes, I can't wink.
All right, let me take you through the options for tonight because I have a feeling we're gonna be here for a while. This is option one. This is an old little Revolve jumpsuit. Got some sparkly heels on. Not really sure about this one. This is probably the most weather appropriate, I would say. All right, this is option number two. A little cute velvet off-shoulder situation. I'm just trying it on with these boots, but I just feel a bit naked. This is what happens when girls get ready. I'm all right.
All right, oh, I quickly need to zhuzh up my hair. Where is my baby? Where are you, my sweet? My sweet, sweet baby. My steam pod. Shit, I need to go in 5 minutes. Crapola. Do I need to fill this up with water now? It's okay. Gonna spray some perfume. Tonight is the Serge Lutin kind of night. This is my sexiest fragrance and I went with option number two. I love layering fragrances, and this by Killian Kissing Fragrance. This is my fragrance. I got this actually when I literally like first started going out again, leaving my house. So it's now my single girl fragrance. Okay, let me wait for this guy to get a bit hot. It's getting hot in here. I feel like I've shown you me using this so many times, but it is life-a-thon, as my sister would say. Hannah's in this phase right now where she adds a thon to everything. I'm not mad at it, but as you guys know, I pick a word and I kill it. Like I overdo the word, like a thon, Hannah-thon. And lit, I was like about 8 years late to the lit party, wasn't I? I just sent Liv like three different options of my outfit. she was like, wear the red one, you're gonna freeze. And you were just sick. I was like, oh, being my mummy. And obviously, being her teenage daughter, I am not wearing the red one. I'm going half naked, but I'm literally getting in a car and out a car. And in a restaurant and out a restaurant. Okay, how quick is that? Yes. Love it.
All right, I am ready for the night. So, let me talk you through my outfit, even though I've already shown you this dress, but I'm wearing this, oh, sorry, ignore the pile of clothes there. I'm wearing this incredible Carl Gaia clutch, which you might have seen in one of my Teresa hauls. Got my little boots on, and I am probably gonna freeze, which is definitely a bad idea considering I lost my voice like last week. Here we are, ready to go inside Isabel's, but I wanted to show you the Christmas lights because they just came on, looking so festive.
Here we go. Oh, wait.
Gemma was born to be on the vlog.
I was born. Your followers are going to be like, Sina, how is that? Such a mess. Why are you?
Just got home from dinner. Oh, my tea is hot and it's burning my hand. Ow, 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 ow. There we go. Oh, I need to go take off my makeup. Now it's burning my throat. That was not a good idea, was it? The food at Isabel is so good if you guys are looking for great dinner in London. It's part of a group. I think it's also Casa Cruz and somewhere else. I'm not sure. But their food was great. Why am I whispering when no one's here? Not even my dog. He's with my mum.